Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Reading from the prophet Isaiah. Comfort, O comfort my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem and cry to her that she has served her term, that her penalty is paid, that she has received from the Lord's hand double for all her sins. A voice cries out, in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be lifted up, and every mountain and hill be made low. The uneven ground shall become level, and the rough places a plain. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all people shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken. A voice says, cry out, and I say, what shall I cry? All people are grass. Their constancy is like the flower of the field. The grass withers, the flower fades, when the breath of the Lord blows upon it. Surely the people are grass. The grass withers, the flower fades, but the word of our God will stand forever. Get you up to a high mountain, O Zion, herald of good tidings. Lift up your voice with strength, O Jerusalem, herald of good tidings. Lift it up, do not fear, says to the cities of Judah. Here is your God. See, the Lord God comes with might, and his arm rules for him. His reward is with him, and his recompense before him. He will feed his flock like a shepherd. He will gather the lambs in his arms and carry them gently in his bosom and gently lead the mother sheep. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
reading from the second letter of Peter. Do not ignore this one fact, beloved, that with the Lord one day is like 1,000 years, and 1,000 years are like one day. The Lord is not slow about his promise, as some think of slowness, but is patient with you, not wanting any to perish, but all to come to repentance. But the day of the Lord will come like a thief, and then the heavens will pass away with a loud noise, and the elements will be dissolved with fire, and the earth and everything that is done on it will be disclosed. Since all these things are to be dissolved in this way, what sort of persons ought you to be in leading lives of holiness and godliness, waiting for and hastening the coming of the day of God, because of which the heavens will be set ablaze and dissolved, and the elements will melt with fire? But in accordance with his promise, we wait for new heavens and a new earth where righteousness is at home. Therefore, beloved, while you are waiting for these things, strive to be found by him at peace, without spot or blemish, and regard the patience of our Lord as salvation. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
In the beginning of the good news of Jesus Christ, the Son of God, as it is written in the prophet Isaiah, "See, I am sending my messenger ahead of you, who will prepare your way, the voice of one crying in the wilderness. Prepare the way of the Lord, make his paths straight." John the Baptizer appeared in the wilderness, proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. And people from the whole Judean countryside and all the people of Jerusalem were going out to see him and were baptized by him in the River Jordan, confessing their sins. Now John was clothed with camel's hair, with a leather belt around his waist, and he ate locusts and wild honey. He proclaimed, "The one who is more powerful than I is coming after me. I am not worthy to stoop down and untie the thong of his sandals. I have baptized you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
The Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. This last November 25th, just a couple of weeks ago,
should have been Nan's and my 51st wedding anniversary. We had the church and the priest and the attendants and the celebration booked for November 25th, 1972. We sent out all the announcements in the traditional way that brides and grooms do. We were telling our world that we were ready to become husband and wife. We had been dating a long time, and it was no surprise, I'm sure, to anyone who received our announcement. As it turned out, we were utterly unable to be married on November 25th, and we would eventually send out not one, but three announcements to the list of our wedding guests. In October, about a month before the planned wedding, I had a very serious stroke at the age of 21. Not exactly something that anyone would expect for such a young person. Turned out that I had a birth defect in the blood vessels of my brain that just chose that moment to present itself and let me know that it was there. And so we sent out our second wedding announcement to the entire list, which began with, due to the serious illness of Guy Adams Drake, the marriage of Guy and Nan will be indefinitely postponed. And on the actual night of November 25th, the hospital staff made this really nice dinner for us. And we had in intensive care at Fairview Southdale, we had this little dinner with a candle. And that was our wedding day. Well, anyway, so for after 2 months more of recovery, we sent out our third announcement that the wedding was rescheduled for January 27th, 1973, everything without a hitch. And next month, on January 27th, 2024, God willing, we will celebrate our 51st wedding anniversary. Thank you, God. So this passage this morning from Mark is all about announcements and pronouncements. We have John the Baptist making an announcement with this proclamation. The one who is more powerful than I is coming after me. I am not worthy to stoop down and untie the thong of his sandals. I have baptized you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit. Now, a proclamation is defined as a public and typically formal statement about a fact, occurrence, or intention, especially one dealing with a matter of great importance. So we send out announcements when there is a matter of great importance in our lives, like weddings, births, graduation, anniversary. And today, those announcements are really probably most commonly made on places like Facebook. And for John, his message relied on getting out into the community via word of mouth. And people from the whole Judean countryside and all the people of Jerusalem were going out to him. It was a real life analog social media that brought out the crowds to see John and to be baptized in the River Jordan. There's never in history been an announcement of greater importance than this one. Because he says he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit. This is like a birth, graduation, wedding, and anniversary all rolled together into one. Somehow John knew, and he proclaimed that knowledge in the exact way that our Old Testament lesson from Isaiah describes it as happening. A voice cries out in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord, make straight in the desert a highway to our God. Recently, we had some guests attending at St. David's, and we, after the service was over, we were talking and kind of introducing ourselves to each other. And they commented right away, it was their first time ever being here, on the welcome in our mission statement in our weekly bulletin. Now, those two paragraphs are really our collective announcement. It's our proclamation of who we aspire to be in fulfilling the mission of the Holy Spirit that John spoke of. So it says, St. David's welcomes you. St. David's Episcopal Church is committed to following Jesus' example of practicing radical hospitality, seeking to find God in all people because they are of sacred worth. We welcome all persons, regardless of gender, race, ethnicity, age, physical or mental capacity, education, sexual orientation, gender identity, socioeconomic or marital status. All are invited as full participants in the life and ministry of our community of faith. And the mission statement goes on to say, we at St. David's Episcopal Church are devoted to loving and serving God, one another, and the world, honoring the dignity and freedom of all to seek God at their own pace. We connect our life stories with the teachings of Jesus. Inspired by the Holy Spirit, we believe our actions transform the world and ourselves. These are not vague statements. They are very specific proclamations of who we are trying to be every day here at St. David. We aren't exactly a voice in the wilderness like John, especially here in Minnetonka, but since 1950, we have been a voice in the neighborhood. That's 70 years of parishioners just like us who tried to answer the call of John the Baptist to receive the Holy Spirit. Generations have entrusted us to maintain that connection to God, the community, and each other. May we always proclaim, as John did, the presence of God in our lives. Amen.
Holy One. reconciliation, healing. We bring our fears into the light of your love. Let us pray for the church, especially we pray for boldness of vision, courage, compassion, creativity, joy, humility, hospitality. Let us taste your life and share your feast. Let us pray in gratitude. Especially we pray for love shared, community formed, the breath of life, beauty all around us. Help us to see your gifts and presence before our eyes. David, Jonathan and Margaret, Jean, Carl, Ben, Trevor, Zhang and Don. We pray for all who are anxious, depressed or lonely. Help us to remember that you are a God of healing.
God of all mercy, we confess that we have sinned against you, the Holy Spirit of our lives.
We have denied your goodness to each other, in ourselves, and in the world you have created. We repent of the evil that enslaves us,
the evil we have done,
and the evil done on our behalf. Forgive us, restore, to strengthen us, through our Savior Jesus Christ, that we may abide in your love, and serve only your will. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through the grace of Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Peace be with you.
Who would want to come back to ask for prayers for yourself, for the world, for someone else. Please know that you can just make your way to the back during the distribution of communion for that. Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us an offering and sacrifice to God. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant which is shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again.
We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O God, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension. We offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And the last day, bring us with all your saints and the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ. By him, and with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty God, now and forever.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
us pray. Eternal God,
Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart, through Christ our Lord.
Good morning. The Magi are on the move with their camel. A little precarious there. Where are Mary and Joseph now? Do we know? Who's got them? The Sarda family. So this is our Posada tradition where we practice radical hospitality for felt people. And and in all seriousness, as a symbol of what it means to welcome others into our home and to share hospitality and then to take them to the next home. So Patty and others, thanks for helping us with Posada. And I just want to say thank you for our music today. What a special treat.
Good morning, I'm Anna, I'm your children and youth minister. And this Wednesday, we are gonna be getting busy in the kitchen. We are gonna be baking Christmas cookies. I have some awesome helpers. Kimberly and Sarah Lee have been so helpful. They really make baking happen. I'm not a baker. And so we're gonna be baking from 6:30 to 8:30, and that is gonna be with our friends from Trinity as well. So we're gonna be making a lot of cookies, and then the following Sunday when we go caroling, those are the cookies that we're gonna bring to folks that we go caroling to. And that is for all ages of children and youth. It's usually a youth group night, but we're opening it up to younger children as well. We just ask under fifth grade for the child to bring an adult with them. And there will be dinner beforehand starting at 6. So if you come at 6 or 6:30, there will be food for you.
Good morning, I'm Allison Farrow, Senior Warden here, and just here to welcome everyone. Thank you for being here today. Welcome any visitors, newcomers, we're glad to have you here. And please join us downstairs for coffee hour and fellowship, and we'll have another announcement about what else is going on downstairs. So thanks for being here.
Good morning, David Niles. Just to echo all that Anna was saying about caroling next week, just a reminder that we'll be going down for the forum and doing some caroling and FaceTime with people and giving everyone the opportunity to sing. And then those who are interested, just because you can go downstairs and sing with no further obligation, but if you'd like, we'll be going out to Hope Springs and a few other places. We'll split into groups so it doesn't take all afternoon. There's a sign-up sheet somewhere around. Please let me know if you have any questions. It's a great event for all ages. The older people that we go visit love seeing kids singing, so hope you can join us. Thank you.
Hello, I am the aforementioned Sarah Lee, and I do bake. And I want to invite you all downstairs for the bake and craft sale going on. I want to mention a couple of things that are special. One, I do a cookie raffle every year. You can, for $1, get your chance at 4 dozen cookies. Diane Curley won last year. And she didn't want Christmas cookies, so I made her Valentine cookies. I take requests, just so you know. And also, I wanted to mention, because Catherine asked me to mention this, I made some cookies in honor of Nita Jacobs. Bill's wife Nita always did decorated cookies. And my boys love them, even though I make decorated cookies. So come on down and check everything out.
Hi, Roger Stratton, Minister of Music. And this Wednesday is the first practice of our Christmas Eve choir. We'll be singing Christmas Eve at the only service, which is at 4:30. And so this Wednesday at 7:15, as the aroma of cookies wafts, we'll be singing familiar carols. It'll be really fun. Anyone and everyone welcome, but let me know if you're coming so I can have enough music. Thank you.
My name is Scott Clark, and I want to announce that on January 30th, as part of educational and spiritual formation, we will have a Zoom night, 6:30 to 8, and it will be led, co-led, by Rector Catherine Lewis and myself, and it will be a discussion on the book that's called The Truth at the Heart of the Lie. And it's also important to understand this is not a book club night, that's a separate night. And I just want to read this one excerpt here. It says, James Carroll's The Truth at the Heart of the Lie is once a passionate love letter to the enduring beauty of the Catholic faith and a passionate indictment of the clericalism of the Catholic Church. This moving and revelatory book, written from deep and personal experience, takes us to the heart of one of the great institutional and existential crises of our times. And I think it's important to understand is that this is not going to be a singular rant against the Catholic Church, is that we're going to approach this book with grace. And I think one of the most important parts of this is maybe two things. Number one is that this book talks about the issues of the power of institutions, especially when we are constantly re-examining the truths behind our theology and the history that has brought us up to this point. And then also I think that a big part of this is James Carroll's personal journey through this. He was a Catholic priest for 5 years and decided not to be part of that institution. And I think that this book, the key word is revelatory, I think for each and every one of us that would like to participate in this discussion. And I think also, lastly, the most important thing is if you have any deep theological questions, that we would spend time doing that. And this is in the bulletin and also a place where you can purchase the book. Thank you.
I'm really looking forward to it, Scott. Thank you. I have two other announcements. One is, on Christmas Eve, we do have the one service at 4:30. We would love to have some simple hospitality after that service, just a little food and drink. If there are a few people within the congregation who would help host that, please let the office know. And finally, this Tuesday, 2 days from now, we will hold our a potluck lunch next door in the ICA building in the Jones Room at 11:30. And we'll hear Kathy and Randy Schwitzenberg talk about their recent pilgrimage. We will also have people have the chance to meet our new office administrator, Nancy, who will be in attendance. And just bring a dish to share, show up. If you can't even find time to make a dish, just come anyway. And the parking, one can park in the ICA parking lot. Just that's really important because the church is going to be really full that day. So park next door at the parking lot at ICA. Good. All right, please stand as you are able for the blessing. The peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of His Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. The blessing of God Almighty, the Creator, the Redeemer, the Sanctifier, be with you this day and remain with you forever. Amen.